We've turned science into a false god. Now, I know, science is a good thing. It gave us the iPhone, it gave us video games, and it's letting me talk to you right now. But what is science, actually? The word comes from a Latin word, scientia, meaning knowledge. But really, science is only one kind of knowledge. It's knowledge of nature in the ancient sense that Aristotle writes about in his Physics. There he says that science is the study of things that happen spontaneously because of the way objects move in space. It's the study of the material world, planets spinning, code running, gears turning. Science is for those sort of things. But not everything is locked into those rules of predetermined logic. There are other things in the world. There's free will, for example, and moral choice. And those go beyond science. They're metaphysical. They're not just about how our bodies work and move in space. They're about how our souls choose. Is it worth risking more deaths of despair just to try and prevent every possible coronavirus case? And who should get to decide? The people or the government? Those aren't questions for science. They're questions for policy and prudence and philosophy. They're matters of moral intuition. But we've lost our belief in everything except physical matter. And that's why John Kerry, whom Joe Biden chose to serve as his special presidential envoy for climate, said that President Joe Biden will trust in God, and he will also trust in science to guide our work on Earth. Those aren't the words of a scientist or even a politician. They're the words of a prophet preaching a false religion. Like every false god, science offers us good things and then turns them into evil. And now we're locked down, impoverished, and desperate for answers that can only really come from one place. Isaiah says, "Come, you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you without money, come, buy, and eat." Until we realize there's something more than matter, we will remain slaves to this false god.